Hey guys, so today I'm going to be showing you how to do a typical satellite radio install. So today we're going to be installing the Sirius Sportster 6 with an FM modulator and two antenna adapters in this application. Okay, let's go over what comes in the box. So you have your unit with a dock, such come out for your windshield, power adapter, your antenna, and a remote. And here I have the FM modulator. I'll show you how this installs. It's pretty simple and easy, but this makes all the difference when you want to do a good installation. So here I'm showing you how a typical person will install that I've seen. So what you're going to do is, what most people do is they're just going to stick it right here, which is acceptable, and then they're going to run inside, and then they're going to have a jumble of wires for a mess. Like, okay, if you're crafty enough, you'll probably tuck this all away, and then, well, we got to give it power, so they're going to typically go over here, the cigarette lighter, but then you're going to have this wire going across your dash. Not very cool. So I'm going to show you how to hide all these wires and do the job properly. Another note you want to make is, by installing the antenna up here and running this way, keep in mind this is like a coaxial wire, there's literally one strand of copper wire in here with a protective sheath over it. As your door closes and keeps slamming on this, it's probably going to be prone to breaking. So what you have to actually do is run this thing either through the door boot, or preferably I like to run through the firewall, making sure that there's no pinching points. Now this is the proper way of doing it. On a nice black car like this Audi, I've gone ahead and taken some 3M paint protector and put that on first, because if you don't put that on, what's going to happen is all the dirt and salt or wherever you're living is going to get trapped under there, and when you remove this, you're going to have a nice little round mark from all the dirt getting caught underneath. So this will protect the paint. And then what you're supposed to do is run underneath the molding of the windshield. We're going to run down here into the engine compartment and into the firewall. That way this thing's never going to pinch. So after when you get your wire in the mold, it's going to look all nice and clean. You won't even really notice that's even there. So next you want to actually get your wiring all run the way you want it. I'm going to go ahead and loom this after and secure it. Before I do that, I have to pull the wire through. So I've already found a grommet to go through. I got my wire ready. It's all taped up. I'm just going to loop it up and pass it through. And to clean it up, just go ahead and loom your wire. You know, zap strap it to make sure it stays out of the way of any pinching points, like over here. And zap strap right over there as well. So the next part of the install is we have to hide the power. You could use a socket like this, where you would wire this up to your power in the ground, and then you just go ahead and put in your power adapter, and then I just tape it up to make sure it's secure. What I'm going to be doing today though is I'm going to be soldering onto your power and the grounds. So here's what it looks like when I have everything soldered on. I got both my grounds together coming off into one, and then here's my power. And I have a fuse in line as well, just to make sure. There is a fuse in here, but just in case, just want to make sure. Now, some of you might be thinking, why didn't I just cut it here and wired it directly to 12 volts? You can't do that because these units actually run at 5 volts. So you have to use this to step it down properly. So because our Audi uses a data signal to turn on the factory stereo, we have to grab the 12 volt signal from the ignition wiring. So we're just going to test it right now. Bear with me, we have two hands to do all this. So ground right now. Turn the ignition on. So that's where we're going to grab power to turn this thing on. So I'm just going to explain the whole idea behind this whole FM modulator thing. So here it is. Very simple device. It plugs in line. So what you do is you take the antenna out of the vehicle, you plug it in here, and then the other end goes back into the deck. So what this does now is when you actually turn on your Sirius or your XM, whatever you got, when this is plugged in and it sees the signal, it pipes in the signal and first into the deck. That way it doesn't have to fight with the aerial outside. Typically on an install, if you don't put that in, you're going to be fighting the local radio station. So, you know, you find a good radio station around your local town, you drive an hour or so outside, and then you pick up another radio station. So you're always fighting the local radio stations. With this installed, you never have to do that. Plug it in once, set your radio station on your Sirius or your XM, and then you never have to fight it again. And when you're all done, go ahead and test it. So yeah, this is a pretty basic installation. In the next scenes, I'll show you some pictures of some other installs where I have it floating in different locations so you get some more ideas. But hopefully that helped you out today, guys.